Hello, my name is Arnaud Delorme, and I'm the main software architect of the EEGLab software for processing EEG data. This is part 4, EEGLab history and usage statistics. So EEGLab, or its sister, was created in 1997 at the SOC Institute. Then in 2001, we had the first version of EEGLab for artifact rejection. At that time, it was only doing artifact rejection, and this was at the SOC Institute. In 2003, we integrated all the tools and we released EEGLab to a wider audience. In 2004, we had specific support from NIH to support EEGLab, and this is the year of the reference paper of EEGLab. In 2006, we implemented group analysis as well as the system to have extension for EEGLab. 2009, we have new associated toolbox, which I'm going to talk about a little bit. 2011, that's when the paper was published showing EEGLab was the most popular EEG software for processing EEG. In 2014, we had the EEGLab plugin manager that allowed you to install plugins from within EEGLab. In 2018, we have the integration with LIMO to perform linear model of EEG data. And 2019, that's what we're working on right now, integration with BIDS and big data pipelines. And so EEGLab is a collection of about 600 functions, 70,000 lines of code. There's about 250,000 downloads over the past 10 years. We have 6,500 users on the discussion list and 15,000 on the diffusion list, which is for more rarer message. We have had NIH funding since 2003. There is about 75 plugins, although there is about 100 plugins right now. And EEGLab has been supporting about $288 million of research in the US. This is by looking at all the papers that use EEGLab and totaling their grants. There's about 140,000 EEGLab sessions per month from about 10,000 users from all over the world, mostly North America, Europe, and China, Asia. In 2011, there was a paper by Hanke and Elchenko that showed that EEGLab was the most used software for processing EEG data. Also, we have the EEGLab reference article, which is above 10,000 citations as in 2019 and seems to still increase. This is a comparison of EEGLab with other software packages, both commercial and field trip. And of course, this is probably biased, but it lists the different types of license, either open source or commercial, user base, and different capabilities of the software. EEGLab, you see, has most greens compared to the other ones. This might not be totally up to date with respect to each of the software, but this allows you, this gives you a rough idea of the field. We also have a page comparing using EEGLab versus commercial software. There's a quote from a researcher called Buchanan in Nature Physics that says, "Can we trust the results of a new paper if it depends on calculation carried out by proprietary software with non-public source code?" So there's a strong push for using software where the source code is open. And we have a point-by-point comparison with leading software packages where open source might be preferable and when a commercial software might be preferable. So I invite you to visit that wiki page. EEGLab is also, the strength of EEGLab is also all the plugins, and we've developed many of them ourselves, and I'm going to present a couple of them right now. And for instance, there is SIFT, Source Information Flow Toolbox, that allows you to calculate brain dynamical activity. There is NFT, Neural Electromagnetic Forward Head Modeling Toolbox, that allows you to do precise source localization of ICA components. And there is a new extension that's called EEGLab and BIDS, and that allows you to import and export in bits format. There's also IC Label, which is a new plugin for automated ICA component labeling. So that's very useful in pipeline. And you can compare, you can go on the website and classify components and compare your performance with experts. There's also in the reference paper a comparison with other methods. And of course, highly biased, there's many other plugins for ICS source rejection. That's just the one we developed in lab. So I invite you to look at the other plugin. To do that, you can use the plugin manager. There's an online version, and that's the version from within EEGLab. So you click on a given plugin and it gives you the rating, the number of downloads, as well as the description of the plugin. There is often also a link to the documentation if documentation is available. So in the next lecture, we'll start to see how to process data in EEGLab.